Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest is a triple threat: actor, singer, author. But who can forget her breakout role as the super smart Akilah in the movie Akilah and the Bee?
Well, now she's putting those squeaky clean roles to the side and branching out into a new movie that's called PIMP. Ooh. It is a coming of age story about a woman taking over her father's pimping business. So take a look.
I got some new girls working for me. It's only going up for me from here.
You either work for me, or you can die.
This is your future, right here. You and me, remember?
Now, I may not have been the best mother in the world, but sometimes you don't get to live the life you want to live.
Oh, my goodness. That's gonna be so good. Please welcome the multi-talented Keke Palmer.
Yes, Keke.
Yes!
Thank you so much
yes
for being
with
here.
This movie.
Oh, she said, you better yes with this movie.
Yeah. Hey, grown up Keke.
Hey, guys, sorry I'm kicking you.
No, it's fine. Welcome to the show. How you doing?
I'm great. Happy to be here. You guys look great.
Thank you so much. Let's take it all the way back to Chi-Town.
Yes.
How did you get from Chicago to Hollywood?
You know, it kind of came crazy. My mom and dad were reading the newspaper about Lion King auditions in Chicago theater. They asked if I wanted to do it. That was my first time ever trying out acting. I used to sing in church. My mom was a choir director. And so after that, I really wanted to start acting. I ended up getting a role in Barbershop 2, playing Queen Latifah's niece. And then as crazy as it sounds, my family was like, okay, you know, should we move to California to give Keke better opportunities and just give her the opportunities that we didn't have? And
yeah.
They hopped up in the car, all six of us, drove 4 days and 3 nights.
Oh, wow. My gosh.
The rest is history.
Look at
oh,
you now.
Oh, my gosh. I mean, you're making history. You know, you're the youngest
Thank
talk
you so
show
much.
That's ever been.
Thank you.
You were the first Black Cinderella on Broadway.
Thank you so
and
much.
You've done all these amazing trailblazing things.
Thank you very
so
much.
Do you feel any pressure to stay on top of yourself and then everybody else?
Yeah, I think definitely I'm always competing with myself. Always, and also just never wanting to let myself down for my passions.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I'm learning as I get older that there are other things that are important in life too. So definitely spending time with family. They're a big part of my life. I've enjoyed this holiday. So it's all about balance. You know, I love what I do, but I also like being and just chilling.
So yeah. How were you able to make sure you kept that balance? Because growing up in the spotlight, for some folks, we see how it ends up.
Yeah.
That's not your story.
Yeah, oh, thank you very much.
Why do you think you've been able to be as successful as you are, having come from being a child star and now a star in your own right as in your 20s?
You know, I think everybody's life is different, so nothing to anyone else. But I think for me specifically, me being able to remain grounded and not being totally overwhelmed with the Hollywood life has a lot to do with my parents. They really didn't expose me to a lot of that at a young age. So once I did get exposed to it, I think I had many years of the opposite to where I was able to kind of gauge what I wanted to be a part of, what I didn't want to be a part of. And at the end of the day, what I do doesn't have to be my lifestyle.
Yes.
I think that's a big thing that I understood also is that at the end of the day, this is my job. It's what I love to do, but I can also go home and just be chilling and I don't have to be all that hoopla. And that helps me to be relaxed.
Good stuff.
Well, you know, you have always played like these good girl roles.
Absolutely, yes.
I mean, and this pimp thing right here, this movie right here, honey. I mean, you have segued from one thing to like the complete opposite, and you are just treating these chicks a certain kind of way. What's going on with it?
Yeah, this is totally different than anything I ever did. And like you say, you know, when I was a kid, it was always the sassy roles. And then after Akilah and so on, it was this quiet or the more girl next door type of roles. And even with True Jackson, it was more comedy girl, you know. And this, I just said to myself, I had been looking right after I did True Jackson came off of that show, I was really looking for something to challenge me.
Because
the reality is, as a creative, when you keep doing the same thing, the same genre, whatever it may be, you get a little stale. And so I was like, how can I whip this up and make this exciting for me again? And I found the script PIMP with my mom, and we both said, you know what? I think this will be a fun challenge for us. And my mom has always been my acting coach.
Yeah.
And so it was exciting. She's always been there for me in every way. And so this was exciting for us both.
Yeah, How were you able to physically and mentally prepare to play a pimp?
Yeah, I think I always believe everything comes in God's time, and this movie was not easy to get made. So I think a lot of the mental preparation happened, you know, also with my personal growth from this time span of 18 to when I was 22 and we actually filmed it.
Okay.
I think a lot of it came just from my life experiences and looking at, you know, different things that I wanted the character to be like. And then on top of that, I actually trained a lot with my trainer. You know, I really wanted my body to look defined and my arms and just what I kind of visually wanted the character to be
look
alongside
like,
with the director.
Yeah. And it came out, honey. You are killing
just,
it.
Just killing the whole game. Just the whole thing. Yes.
And you know, we're going to have so much more with Keke Palmer, and she's telling us all about her new music, so you guys stay right chill. Sister Circle Live. We are continuing our conversation with the multi-talented Keke Palmer.
Yes, love it, love it. So singing or acting, which one? Or is it a toss-up? Is there equal? Who wins?
Yeah, it's definitely hard to decide. Mm-hmm. I think what I really love is when I get to do how usually you would do in theater. Like, mm-hmm. So I love when I did Grease Live. I love when I did Star. I love when I can marry them both.
Yes.
You know, mm-hmm. I can go back to that old school way. You know?
Yeah. Wow. Good stuff.
So we were looking at your song just now, Better to Have Loved.
Yeah.
So tell us about how that song came to fruition.
So I was in the studio with Tasha, my boy Alex, and Queso, and I've been working with them a lot on this new project. And pretty much, you know, we have conversations. Mm-hmm. You know, we talk about what's going on in my life, and that's how we create the records. And so that's pretty much what happened with Better to Have Loved.
Yeah.
You know, started on this, and it was just about kind of the topics that we've shared in my state of mind.
Yeah, yeah. So let's go back to the movie. That's a good thing. Yeah. So DMX played your dad in this movie?
Yes, he did. And DMX is so iconic.
Yeah.
So iconic, so brilliant. And I've always wanted to meet him, and so to be able to do the movie with him was a double whammy for me.
Yeah.
And Lee Daniels. You're working with Lee Daniels.
Yes, so Lee Daniels I've wanted to work with for a very long time. And, you know, he also does Star, which he allowed me to join on, which was awesome. But he also is executive producer of PIMP, which came to me as a surprise, just for him to be... to believe in my role and to believe in the movie when it's such a small indie movie, you know what I mean? It really meant a lot to me.
Yeah, and this is like, obviously sex trafficking and all of that is going on now. And then the time that it's coming out leading into the Super Bowl here in Atlanta, you know, it goes on a lot. So why did it resonate with you so much, this particular role?
I think it was really on more so the kind of part that everybody can relate to, which is growing up trying to reverse generational curses.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm.
Trying to break free from some of the down plots that people in your family did and not knowing any better, but still trying and believing through faith that you can overcome those challenges.
Yeah.
I think that's the part of the movie that really stuck with me.
Yeah, wow. That's good.
So what's next for you, Keke?
Man, tons of stuff. I have Star coming out. You know, I'm still on Star. Love Star. Love working on that show. Got good music coming from there.
Oh, great.
Also have Berlin Station that premiered this month. Mm-hmm. So I'm on my second season of that. It's the third season of the show, and I'm a spy.
Yes.
So if you're into political, noir, sci-fi, all that stuff, then that's what you're into, and you should check that show out. And then also I have the music coming out. A lot of music, a lot of visuals coming at the top of the year.
Good. Don't forget to check out Keke and this groundbreaking film, PIMP. It's available on all digital platforms. And for those of you staying with us for the full hour, Keke joins us at the table next day, right where you are.